Let me give you a
hint. He left you a gold.
Oh, be that way. I'm gonna have some chips.
Alright. Okay, let me give you a quick introduction to CETA and the Trans-Pacific Partnership.
Do we have that already?
Yes.
Can you tell me what the CPTPP stands for?
Sure, CPTPP stands for Comprehensive and Progressive Trans-Pacific Partnership.
Comprehensive
and Progressive.
And Progressive.
Trans-Pacific Partnership.
Trans-Pacific, that's ridiculous.
It is. And it used to be just TPP, now it's more than that, it's CPTPP. Anyways.
CPTPP.
Yeah. Tongue twister.
Thank you.
All right. So let's talk about CETA first. CETA, or Comprehensive Economic and Trade Agreement between Canada and European Union, it was originally signed in 2014 or so. However, it took a few years for this agreement to be fully ratified and implemented by all 28 European countries and Canada. So that's why the agreement only became effective last fall in September. However, it's not fully implemented, and what that means is that now 98% of Canadian goods are duty-free in Europe, and it will change to 99% within the next 3 to 5 years. In comparison, only 25% of Canadian goods were duty-free in European Union before CETA was in place. So it's a huge advantage for Canadian economy. Also, CETA has clauses such as labor mobility, a reduction of the regulation of trade and services. So it's not only about trading goods, it's much more, it's much more comprehensive, that's why it is called comprehensive. Now, what exactly it means for food industry? Means that Europe altogether consumes 16% of the world's total agricultural and food imports. And combined, the European Union is our fourth largest export market of agriculture and food products. And right now, CETA already eliminated tariffs on the most of the Canadian food products. So you're more than welcome to take advantage of it. This is the list of all 28 members of the European Union. Please know that the United Kingdom is still part of the European Union until it formally leaves it. However, I don't think it will happen in the next 2 to 3 years. It may take even longer than that.
Yeah.
Yes, it's unprecedented. It's an unprecedented event, and they just.
By which point they'll change their minds?
Yeah,
exactly.
Wait, this seems like a lot of work.
Yeah, exactly. Mm. Or they have conservatives now. They labor party will get back in power anyway. Yeah, things like that. Things of this nature can happen. So now let's talk about Trans-Pacific Partnership, CPTPP. This is the multilateral agreement between Canada and 10 other countries all across Pacific. Altogether, all the countries represent 495 million people, good size. And the purpose of it is strategically align Canada with key markets in Asia and Latin America. In terms of agriculture and food, the Trans-Pacific Partnership will give us preferential access to the markets where we had difficulties entering before, such as Japan, Vietnam, Malaysia, and some other countries. Another good thing about those markets is in most of them the population is growing and the economy is getting better, so people will buy more food, buy more quality food, and Canadian food producers and manufacturers can take advantage of those trends. Upon full implementation of the agreement, Canadians will have duty-free access to those markets. However, we must keep in mind that the agreement is signed, but it's not fully implemented yet, so the duties are still there, where they were. And it will take our estimate about 3 years. We just compared with CETA. So CETA took about 3 years. So we believe that it will also take about 3 years. Now, member states include obviously Canada, but also Australia, Brunei, Chile, Japan, Malaysia, Mexico, New Zealand, Peru, Singapore, and Vietnam.
Yeah. And I think in Vietnam, there's a chess commissioner, they told me five in 6 years.
Oh.
Yeah. Not now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, it will take time, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Now, let me tell you.
Sure. These countries are brand new, or what's going on in 5 years? Sorry, I was just
kind of. In 5 years, we expect changes. We expect that. Canadians will have duty-free access, because right now, even though the agreement is signed, it's not implemented right away. It's not enforced, correct.
And those are all the countries that signed the agreement.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We still have some bilateral agreements between some of these countries.
Correct, yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So essentially, companies can just pick whichever agreement that might be the most favorable to them,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. Yeah, to your point, Shirley, that's exactly what I wanted to cover. The other markets that have bilateral agreements with Canada, I'll just read them aloud. Chile, Colombia, Costa Rica. Now, there is also an organization called European Free Trade Association, and it includes all European countries, all major European countries and economies that are not members of the EU, such as Switzerland, Norway, Iceland, and the liberal country of Liechtenstein. Honduras, it's also in Latin America. In the Middle East, Israel and Jordan. In Asia, it's Korea. That's a brand new. It was also enforced last year. The agreement with Korea. Now, going back to Latin America, Panama and Peru. Ukraine, in Eastern Europe, and the US and Mexico, which is still part of NAFTA. So, those are the countries with which we have free trade agreements. It means that in 99.9% of the cases, food products are duty free. Okay. Now, this is not the complete list, because Canada constantly negotiates agreements with other markets, other countries. And we currently negotiate agreements with a Caribbean community called CARICOM. So this is an association of a bunch of Caribbean countries. I couldn't even put a list of all of them here, because there are so many of them. Canada also negotiates with El Salvador, Guatemala, Nicaragua, and Dominican Republic, so quite a lot of focus on Latin American and Caribbean region. India, Japan, Singapore, and Morocco. And we're currently in exploratory discussions with those organizations and countries. Exploratory discussions means that we are way, way, way early in the process, and look at probably 10 years perspective. China, Philippines, Thailand, and Turkey, big Asian economies, also started discussions with ASEAN, that's the Southeast Asian Economic Association, in Mercosur, the alliance of largest economies of South America. Uruguay is probably not the largest one, but they're kind of in between Argentina and Brazil, so I guess they don't have a choice. In the Pacific Alliance, we kind of saw these countries already, so I don't really believe that there will be a lot of progress, because we already have agreements with Colombia, Chile, Mexico, and Peru, so what's the point? But we'll see. And that's pretty much it, so that's the overview of free trade agreements. In your case, India is still not there, so we're gonna have to wait. Other than that, Vietnam just got we just had an agreement with Vietnam within Trans-Pacific Partnership, and while US is still there, hopefully we'll still be there. The point is that when you target export market, it's a good idea to check whether it is on the list of those with which Canada has free trade agreement. Because again, it means that the your goods will be duty free in that part. Okay. Any questions?
See the cafeteria restrictions in place.